What is going on, everyone? My name is Eskimo, and welcome to my new Let's Play of Skyrim, and I am very excited to bring you guys this. I know the game's been out for like a year now, but honestly, Skyrim's just been one of those games that I really do love, and I've always wanted to do a full Let's Play of it. So basically, I'm going to be starting a new character, and with this character, I'm going to hopefully get you guys attached to it, like feel a personal connection to it. That's my overall goal, so let us begin. And once we get to the character creation screen, I shall tell you more. So let's see, start a new game, yes. So yeah, I just finished up my Dragonborn Let's Play, and guys seemed to really like that, and they wanted me to do a full Let's Play of Skyrim, so that's what I am doing right now. And here I am, a level 1. And with this character, I'm going to be doing something I've never done before. I'm actually going to be doing a hardcore roleplay, I'm going to be doing stuff that my character would do. I would be eating, I'm going to be sleeping, and obviously I may fail once or twice with that. I might get into a cave and lose track of time, you know. You can't always keep track of time when you're in a cave, especially in the very massive dungeons, like, say, if I were to do the Dawnguard DLC, and if I got into the Forgotten Vale, that dungeon is just incredibly massive, and I could easily lose track of time. So, like I said, it may not be perfect, but to the best of my abilities, I'm going to be eating, I'm going to be sleeping, and doing everything I possibly can. So, some of that hard-earned gold that I'm going to be getting from dungeons, I obviously have to spend on food and drink, rather than just hoarding it and spending it on awesome armor and stuff like that. So it should be very interesting to see. So yeah. And I forgot to mention, I am doing this on the Xbox 360, but, you know, that's okay. Hopefully you guys will enjoy anyways. So Bethesda Game Studios presents I remember this place. It's very ethereal and atmospheric. It definitely gets you into Skyrim. Let's look at it. It's beautiful. And that's all I can really say to describe this. It's amazing. One of my favorite starts to an Elder Scrolls game ever.
Hey, you. You're finally awake.
Yeah, I'm awake.
You were trying to cross the border, right? You walked right into that Imperial ambush. Same as us. And that thief over there.
Damn you Stormcloaks. Skyrim was fine until you came along. Empire was nice and lazy. If they hadn't been looking for you, I could have stolen that horse and been halfway to Hammerfell. You there. You and me. We shouldn't be here. It's these Stormcloaks the Empire wants.
We're all brothers and sisters in binds now, thief.
Shut up back there.
What's wrong with him, huh?
Watch your tongue. You're speaking to Ulfric Stormcloak, the true High King.
Ulfric? The Jarl of Windhelm? You're the leader of the rebellion. But if they've captured you... Oh, gods. Where are they taking us?
I don't know where we're going, but Sovngarde awaits.
No, this can't be happening. This isn't happening.
Hey, what village are you from, horse thief?
Why do you care?
A Nord's last thoughts should be of home.
Rorikstead. I'm from Rorikstead.
General Talia, sir. The headsman is waiting.
Good. Let's get this over with.
Sure. Mara, Dibella, Kinnereth, Akatosh, Divines, please help me.
So here is Helgen, where we are being delivered.
Look at him. General Tully is the military governor.
To our execution.
It looks like the Dalmor are with him. Damn elves. I bet they had something to do with this. This is Helgen. I used to be sweet on a girl from here. Wonder if Velod is still making that mead with juniper berries mixed in. Funny. When I was a boy, Imperial walls and towers used to make me feel so safe.
I definitely don't feel safe right now.
Where are they going?
You need to go inside, little cub.
Why? I want to watch the soldiers.
Inside the house.
That's nice that his father isn't gonna let him watch a execution.
Why are we stopping?
Just little touches like that make the game so much better.
End of the line. Let's go. Shouldn't keep the gods waiting for us.
Nope.
No, wait, we're not rebels.
Face your death with some courage, thief.
You've got to tell them we weren't with you. This is a mistake.
Step towards the block when we call your name. One at a time!
Empire loves their damn lists.
So...
Ulfric Stormcloak, Jarl of Windhelm.
It has been an honor...
I guess we'll talk in a minute.
Raelof of Riverwood. Lokir of Rorikstad.
No! I'm not a rebel! You can't do this!
Halt!
You're not gonna kill me!
Archers!
He's done for.
Anyone else feel like running?
He didn't get that far.
Wait. You there. Step forward. Who are you?
Okay, so here we begin with what I'm going to be naming my character, a little bit of backstory. So basically, I'm going to be a Khajiit. And I've never been a Khajiit before in any of the Elder Scrolls. And I really wanted to do this because, you know, like I said, I've never been a Khajiit in any of the Elder Scrolls. So I thought this would be interesting to do. And the name of the character is actually going to be Kevin the Khajiit. And basically, a little bit of backstory on Kevin the Khajiit. He was born in an orphanage. He's an orphan, you know, he didn't have family. He never knew his family or anything like that. And he's going to be a very tiny person, very tiny disposition. And as you can see, he has darker skin, so that means, like, he's going to be more of a thief character. He blends in with the darkness. And I'm hoping to get rid of that, those ear jewelry. I don't really like that. Maybe, let's see. Yeah, let's see. War paint color. Let's check out some war paint. Should definitely do some war paint because, like I said, he is a thief character, so I think that would be a bit fitting, that very dark mark on his head. On his face, so like one half is very dark and the other half is a bit paler, so it's kind of menacing if you were to see his face. Let's see, complexion. Obviously we want to make it as dark as we possibly can. No dirt. Actually dirt, yeah, dirt makes sense because, like I said, he was an orphan, so he's a bit dirty, but you know. So let's see, darker. Nose type. I'm not going to get too in-depth with this. I mean, this looks pretty good as it is. If you ask me, like, you know, might change the eye color. Like, I really like that eye color. It's very piercing. Like, you notice his face and you just notice his eyes. So it's very menacing. And let's see. So Kevin the Khajiit, the orphan. And after he left the orphanage, you know, he pretty much did small jobs to... Well, small-time crime jobs, not like being a woodcutter or anything like that. He stole, pickpocketed, and while he was around, I'd say Riften. Yeah, let's go with Riften. He got caught and was taken to Helgen for his execution. So, like, he was trying to steal from the Jarl of Riften. Or actually, not the Jarl, the Jarl of Riften. And is now being taken to Riften for his execution. So let's see, facial hair. I think the facial hair makes him look a bit more menacing, if you ask me. Yeah, there we go. Ooh, that white definitely doesn't work. So let's see, hair color. Oh yeah, definitely get rid of those beads. Should we do some hair? I don't know, maybe. Let's see what the hair looks like on him. I liked him how it was, the default. Yeah, we'll go with this. He has zero hair, but I think he looks very menacing as it is. So yes, we have a very menacing character named Kevin the Khajiit. So this series is going to be the Tales, but the Tales is going to be with a T-A-I-L-S. I thought that'd be kind of ironic, so yeah, his name is just Kevin. Khajiit names are usually like a Shiva hides her tail or something like that, but his name is just Kevin because he was just found in an orphanage, and that was the name that came to the Nord caretaker's mind. So yeah, and obviously he grew up around Riften, so his name is Kevin the Khajiit. So hopefully you guys will get a personal connection with this character like I plan on doing.
What should we do? He's not on the list.
Forget the list, he goes to the block.
Well, that's nice of her.
By your orders, Captain. I'm sorry, we'll make sure your men are turned to elsewhere. Follow the captain, prisoner.
Time to go to my execution, it seems. That's unfortunate.
Ulfric Stormcloak. Some here in Helgen call you a hero, but a hero doesn't use a power like the voice to murder his king and usurp his throne. You started this war. Plunge Skyrim into chaos. And now the Empire is going to put you down and restore the peace.
And there is that dragon.
It's nothing. Carry on.
Yes, General Tullius. Give them their last rites.
As we commend your souls to Aetherius, blessings of the eight divines upon you.
For the love of Talos, shut up and let's get this over.
Learn our...
As you wish.
Come on! I haven't got all morning.
This is gonna be gruesome, I can already tell you that. So if you don't like gore, turn your head away.
My ancestors were smiling at me, Imperials. Can you say the same?
Well, I guess now you can look back. That's over with. I like how his head goes straight into a basket. I mean, I wouldn't want to pick it up after his head was decapitated.
As fearless in death as he was in life.
Next, the cat!
Here it is again. Did you hear that?
I said, next.
Oh, looks like it's my turn to die.
Nice and easy.
I suppose, though, whenever I do escape Helgen, I'll talk a little bit more about the backstory of my character. But there's the dragon, just in time to save me from my sure death, my execution. But there is Alduin, and as you guys can notice, I do have subtitles on, so even if you can't hear what they're saying, you can obviously see that, so yeah. Let's go! And it is time to run around Helgen. Alright, so Roloff wants us to run through here, I think. Is it in here? Yep.
Jarl Ulfric, what is that thing? Could the legends be true?
Legends don't burn down.
So here's more Stormcloaks, and it looks like they're injured. But that's not
up through the tower.
A good Let's condition go. To be through, obviously. When a dragon is attacking, so hopefully they make it out alive. If not, that's not good.
We just need to move some of these rocks.
Uh-oh. Ooh. Who was that right? Oh, that was a Stormcloak. I feel sorry for him. Oh, I can't get up there. Oh.
See the inn on the other side?
through the roof and keep going.
All right, so I forgot about this, that I have to actually jump through over here. So we just barely made that, and can we see our character yet? No, we can't see our character yet. And that's unfortunate, but let's see. Let's sprint over here. So here's Hadvar.
Now! Bada boy, you're doing great. Toral!
Everyone get back! Yeah, I'm standing behind this rock.
Still alive, prisoner? Keep close to me if you want to stay that way.
Oh, I do want to live.
Gunnar, take care of the boy. I have to find General Tullius and join the defense.
God's guide you, Hadvar.
So Hadvar is a very likable Imperial. He was like, this guy's not on the list to be executed. What do we do with him? But that female Imperial captain, she was like, screw him. He dies. So obviously my character has mixed feelings about the Imperials already, but... And just for that reason, I'll probably end up joining the Stormcloaks, but that remains to be seen. And for a second, I thought my character was dead, but nope, I'm not dead. I was like, no! Not already! Not Kevin! Kevin, no! But yes, this is the tale of Kevin the Khajiit. Facing sudden death, but escaping it at Helgen by the sheer luck of fate, by a dragon attacking. So I can either enter with Hadvar or Rolossa, but I think I should go with, since I have mixed feelings about them, that I should go with Hadvar. But Roloff would make most sense because he's like there with me, but you know, I don't really have, I'm a loner, so I'll go with Hadvar just to learn more about the Imperials and get my feelings correct on them and see how that goes. But yeah, normally I would pick Roloff in a normal let's play, but since my character is more of a loner, he's the thief type character, he doesn't really have any allegiances, he's acting on his own accord, his own agenda, and whatever he wants to do, he'll do. So he doesn't really care about Roloff, even though
was that really a dragon? The bringus of the end times?
Normally you'd have more of a connection to him, but he just wants to learn more about Hadvar, so... So my hands are still bound.
Let's cut you loose. There you go. Take a look around. There should be plenty of gear to choose from. I'm going to see if I can find something for these bones.
And look at Kevin the Khajiit. So finally I am free and I can talk about my character a little bit. Can we see the map? Okay, there we go. We can see the map already. So let's see the world map. Alright, so we'll go over here. My character grew up in a Riften orphanage. He was abandoned at an early age, so he never knew his parents. And since he's a Khajiit, you know, the other people at the orphanage made fun of him because, you know, he's more of a loner. Like, you guys know that the Khajiit often travel in caravans and aren't really welcome in the cities. So he wasn't really welcome at the orphanage. Kids often made fun of him. So this caused Kevin to be a bit more of a loner, and he had to rely on himself and couldn't rely on others. So, he was constantly stealing from the other children from the orphanage, you know, like, he'd steal an apple if he was hungry or something like that, or some gold pieces, and slip out of the orphanage and go down to the local market and buy something like a sweet roll. You know how sweet rolls are in Skyrim, they're delicious, but yeah, once he was obviously old enough to get kicked out of the orphanage, he left the orphanage and started doing... his own thing around the country. He traveled from city to city, just blending in, doing odd jobs like pickpocketing people, you know, breaking into houses at night, being a cat burglar or a Khajiit burglar, whatever you want to call it, and just getting him some money, you know, no big jobs. But finally, when he first attempted his very first big job at Riften, he tried to rob the Jarl of Riften. So obviously, he's not the greatest thief, even though he is a Khajiit. His thieving abilities just come from natural talent. That explains such low level in this Let's Play right now. And as you see me go on throughout this Let's Play, I'll obviously level up and progress and become better. So that makes sense from a role-playing standpoint, but yeah, obviously he got caught at Riften and was taken all the way to Helgen, so I think you guys may have noticed him traveling through the mountains, so traveled all the way across from Riften, blah blah blah, into Helgen. And that's why he is at Helgen right now. Whew. I'll be honest, sorry. And trying to find some equipment and with Hadvar. So let's see. In the Warden's chest, there's some Imperial Light Armor. I'll go with the... We'll put the armor on. Just for the sake of having armor, but I don't think we'll actually wear it. I could go with a dagger if I could possibly find it. There's an Imperial Light helmet. But I'm not going to wear a helmet because, I don't know, I don't think it looks good on Kevin. Kevin is a very handsome Khajiit, obviously. And, you know, very handsome. Gets all the ladies. Taking some gold. Alright, here we go. And that door's open. I really wish I could find a dagger. This way. But right now we're just following Hadvar.
We need to get moving. That dragon is tearing up the whole keep.
Hear that? Stormcloaks. Maybe we can reason with them.
Nope. Never should have. Definitely can't reason with them. Definitely can't reason with these Stormcloaks, but we're gonna kill them anyways. So, oh my goodness, look at Kevin in combat. He just looks absolutely menacing. I can only imagine him what he looks like with Nightingale armor or something like that. So there is Gunyar. Don't really have anything I really want, but, you know, I'm going to take the Stormcloak armor and check out that sexy little lady on the ground. I'm going to take the Stormcloak armor so see if I was going to go into a Stormcloak city at the start to wear it. I could wear it, blend in, Imperial City, wear it, you know, blend in. So that... Oh, I'll have both armor for right now to go back and forth. Here's some cabbage. Cabbage, yummy. Food. My first food for my Let's Play. So here we are, guys. My character's a bit hungry. Obviously, this is his first meal ever since he's going on to... Since he's going to be executed. So, yeah. If only I could have some meat or something like that to wash down the cabbage. Yeah, I could only imagine eating a full head of cabbage. What that would be like. But oh well. Or actually two full heads, because I ate two. Here seems to be like a kitchen of some sorts.
What are you doing? We need to get out of Helgen now.
These Imperials have potions in here. We're going to need them.
Don't look at me. I was hoping they wouldn't look at me and I'd get the sneak attack, but unfortunately that didn't happen. But you know, still got a good angle and stabbed her in the back. So. Or no, is that a guy? I couldn't tell. Okay, see if we can find some potions. There we go. Stamina. I'm not gonna be using spells. You know, normally I would use spells to heal my character, but since I'm gonna be role playing, my character's gonna be more of a thief, which means I'm gonna be using bow and arrows and daggers and light armor. So that is gonna be my full skill set. It's all of what I'm gonna use unless I have to use it for like a quest or something like that. And now we're just gonna look around, check out what's around here, put some more potion of minor healings, you know. I thought this was like a kitchen of some sort. There's some Alto wine. So yeah, we got some wine already. We can start drinking and stuff like that. Let's check if there's any more food around here. No, that was just that one barrel. And we're gonna go through this door now.
Done then. This way. The torture room. Gods, I wish we didn't need these.
Oh. Hear looks that. Like it's a back and forth battle.
My work.
Unless you plan to stay and help. Leave me to my word.
Oh, what?
A dragon is attacking hell.
A dragon. Please, don't make up
nonsense.
That's
a high elf.
Although, come to think of it, I did hear some odd noises coming from over there.
Come with us. We need to get out of here.
You have no authority over me, boy.
Didn't you hear me? I said the keep is under attack.
Forget the old man. I'll come with you.
Wait a second. Looks like there's something in this cage.
Don't bother with that. Lost the key ages ago. Poor fellow screamed.
So it gave me some lock picks, but I'm gonna check in here to see if there's anything like that I could use. Okay, here is a dagger. So we finally got a dagger, and there's some lock picks. So, you know, it already gave me some lock picks, but we're gonna use the dagger. Ooh, only four hit points. That kind of stinks, but you know, it'll obviously move up and get better. So let's see. I'm gonna pick this lock. I already know how to lock pick. See, that's not gonna be it. Ooh, here we go. There we go, we got that. Very first lock pick. And just, I was gonna say check out what he has, but. And spell tome sparks. You know, we could just take it to learn it. Just for the sake of it, might as well. Normally, I would say, I'd screw this or forget about this lock because it's no, there's nothing in it, but obviously I can use it to get XP right now, and I think I'm gonna end up killing the torturer. I wonder what would happen then, because I don't really like the torturer. He's a high elf, seems very pompous, and that's the type of person that my character doesn't like. So definitely the Thalmor, my character does not like at all. I guess we'll go on, because obviously I'd be killing him in plain sight right now, and I don't want to do that for the sake of if I were to possibly get caught. That wouldn't be good. It looks like there's a coin person there. You know, coin purses typically have like 46 gold or something like that. Depends on what your loot is, or there's something that governs how much gold you get whenever you're finding loot. So. I don't know exactly, but we'll just go on. There's Torture's assistant. He seems like a nice guy, but not very bright. Just checking on around right now. And here, yeah, look at it. My character just blends in with the shadows.
Where in Oblivion are we supposed to go? Where's the way out?
Just give me a minute. Let me think.
Well, here we go. We're gonna attack the Stormcloaks right now. Oh, I fell off. That's not good. But I can move very fast around the battlefield, so that is a bonus to using a dagger. Yeah, I can move very fast, which is always a bonus, but let's check around this room to see if we can possibly find anything. There's people with bow and arrows over here, so we'll try and use a bow and arrow if we can. So let's see, check this corpse really quick. Longbow, some arrows. Oh, the torturer's assistant was killed. Was killed by this guy. Wow. I actually kind of liked him. He was a friendly fellow. But we'll take the bow and arrow. I'll equip it. So let's see. Favorite it. But we'll use it for right now. So there we go, guys. We got the bow and arrow. And we're going to start using our stealthy abilities with this bow and arrow. So we got a dagger and a bow and arrow. Not the best of equipment, but it's a start. You know, it's better than nothing. Obviously, I'm not going to have Daedric armor. And an Adric dagger just starting off the Skyrim Let's Play, unless I modded it in or something like that. Which I'm playing on the Xbox, and there's no mod in anyways. Unless you use Horizon. Okay. So I suppose we have to find a new way out. I don't think I'm supposed to be going up here, but You know, it's probably like something like, hey, come up here and you can find more gold. So yeah, that's what we're finding up here. Let's see if there's going to be anything up here. No, just a dead end like I thought it was going to be. Which is unfortunate, but you know, you'll obviously run into that. Well, oh, that's what I said, but let's check around.
Let's keep moving.
Yeah, this is obviously the way that we have to go. More coin purses. I'm not going to complain about that. Ooh, a spider. See if we can hit that from here. I'm actually not a fantastic archer whatsoever, so it should be interesting to see actually how well I do. Like, you know, I'm decent. You know, I hit all those shots. Well, not all of them. I missed like the first two, maybe. Oh. But I can all hit shots every now and then, you know. I'm not horrible.
What next? Giant snakes.
I hope there's not giant snakes. And if you guys know what the giant snake men are in the Elder Scrolls lore, you are my hero. I think that was a nice little joke to throw in. What's next? Giant snakes? Giant snake men. Freaking Akavir from... Yeah, I want to go to that continent. I'm tired of this continent. It sucks. Alright, so... Let's check around right now. And see... We'll see nothing around here. And... Yeah, we see nothing around here. But let's check it around. Nothing right there.
Hold on. There's a bear.
Oh,
there.
A bear. See? Okay.
I'd rather not tangle with her right now. Just take it nice and slow and watch
my wine. Yummy. We're gonna get drunk. Oh yeah, we're gonna get drunk after we leave Helgen. So, Hadvar gave me a bow and arrow, and we killed the bear on the very first shot. I am the sneaking type, leave me alone. I'm just checking around for some more enemies right now. I don't see any, so I'll probably be moving. But that bear pelt will be nice to sell. You know, that's some pretty easy cash for right now. It could equal out to be a meal. You know, sell the bear pelt, get a nice venison steak and some mead. You know, that'll be nice, won't it? Checking around right now, though. There's some blood on the ground. That's not a good sight. It never is. Blood on the ground. It's never a good sight. But we can check around right now.
This looks like the way out. I was starting to wonder.
All right, so we made it to the way out, guys. To Skyrim we go. All right, I'm not complaining. To Skyrim. And yeah, guys, should be a fun experience. The entire tale of Kevin the Khajiit. I know it's a funny little title, but it's definitely going to be a fun experience. I'm really going to have a lot of fun with this Let's Play, and hopefully you guys will end up feeling a connection to this character. But let's check around right now. Oh, there's the dragon. It's flying off into the distance. Looks like it's going towards Whiterun and Riverwood. Better go warn them.
Looks like he's gone for good this time. But I don't think we should stick around to see if he comes back. Closest town from here is Riverwood. My uncle's the blacksmith there. I'm sure he'd help you out. It's probably okay. Best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help.
So, me and Hadvar are going to be splitting up for right now. No, Hadvar, I liked you. Why must you leave me? No, I'm just kidding. It's more for my character to be traveling alone, so I don't think I'm going to have a follower right now. Maybe later on down the line, my character will start feeling closer to other people, but all his life he's been a loner, and now he's about to tackle the entire wilderness of Skyrim. So I think this would be a very great place to end the very first episode right here. And next episode, we'll be traveling on and continuing the tale of Kevin the Khajiit. So yeah, hopefully you guys will enjoy the series. I know it's going to be a long one, but hopefully you guys will feel such a connection to Kevin that you'll want to see his tale drive forward, or carry on. So yeah, there's the tale of Kevin the Khajiit. Sexy tale, isn't it? But yeah, guys, I've been Eskimo. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and if you did, be sure to leave a like, a comment, a favorite, and all that wonderful stuff, because it really does help me out and lets me know that you guys want me to continue this series and that you want to see more. And also be sure to leave a comment down below letting me know what you think about this series, because I really do want to know. I want to know what you guys think, if you like it, if you think it's a good idea. But as always, guys, I've been Eskimo. I love you all, and I will see you next time.